Yo, what is going on, guys? Extra Fusion here, and Black Ops Cold War is coming out really, really damn soon. So I thought it'd be fun to do a video talking about what this game needs to do to be the best Call of Duty of all time, because it is honestly very possible for that to be the case. It can be, but there's a few things that I think will have to happen in each mode for that to be the case. And of course, remember, best is subjective. You cannot objectively tell me this will be the best Call of Duty, or this is going to be the best Call of Duty, or you can't objectively tell me which COD is the best. No, it is all your own opinions. So me in this video, this is all my opinion. It's a very opinionated video. Some of this stuff might not mean shit to you guys, while it might mean a lot to me. That's just how opinions work. So for example, campaign is not nearly as important to me as multiplayer and zombies are. So even if campaign is absolutely dog shit in this game, the game could still be fantastic. It can be. Black Ops 3 is a good example. Campaign wasn't very good, but the game is still a top 2 COD in my opinion because of how great the multiplayer and the zombies are. So, without further ado, let's just hop into it and just go through each of the mode, talking about what I really think this mode needs to do to possibly be the greatest of all time. And to me, that would be better than Black Ops 2, because Black Ops 2 is, in my opinion, the best COD game so far. So, starting off with the campaign, it's gotta be two things. Epic and emotional. Those are the only two things I'm asking for, and I'll tell you why, right? So Call of Duty campaigns, I'll be honest, usually don't have the best stories to them. They usually don't. Let's be real here. They're usually very generic war stories, and we love them for their epicness and their intensity and the crazy set pieces. That's what we love them for. Do we really love them for the story? I don't really know. Black Ops 1, I think, has probably the best story out of any COD campaign, but I don't think it's still the best campaign because it's not nearly as epic and awesome with the soundtracks and such as like Modern Warfare 2. And I really, really like Black Ops 2 as well. Some of the stuff they have with the characters there. So I think Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2 are probably the best proponents of having good story when it comes to the campaigns. But I'm not really looking for that. It's a video game. I'll be honest with you guys, I don't really look for story in video games. Although it's nice to have a good story there, I'm not going to be looking out for it. But if the missions themselves are really epic and like just entertaining to play, and they have good emotion in there, and the story needs to be at least decent for me to be emotional for it, because look at Modern Warfare 2, Roach and Ghost, when they died, I'll be honest, it's not that emotional. We just get emotional about it because it's like, you know, it's like meme to get emotional about it, you know? But do we really get sad? We didn't know much about them. It's not really that upsetting. What was actually kind of emotional, though, is in Black Ops 2, when you had Mason die by the hands of yourself if you shot him. That's like kind of emotional then. And then you see Hudson die. And it's like these characters that you actually kind of learn a little bit about. So if they make us actually care about these characters and then have maybe something terrible happen to them by the end of it, and they can actually make me like emotional, that's a successful campaign in my opinion, in terms of the story and the characters specifically, not really the overarching story, just the characters themselves. That's all I'm asking for from the campaign. Like I said, if the campaign flops, I don't really care too much, because what I'm looking forward to mostly is the multiplayer and the zombies, which, let's get onto the multiplayer talk, because multiplayer, we've already had some decent tastes of it through the alpha and the beta, and I gotta say, I enjoy it, but I don't love it right now. Like, it's not at the place where I would say it's possible to be the best multiplayer of all time. Like, if I was to just base it off of the beta build of the game itself, but of course, the full game's gonna be more complete, it's gonna have more stuff in it, more stuff for us to mess with, and I'm sure a lot of the issues I had with the beta will probably be fixed, or at least tweaked in some way, shape, or form. So I need to play the full game at least for a little bit to really get that full feel for the full game. But what the multiplayer, in my opinion, needs, let's just go through these three things. So first of all, I'd say the most important thing is replayable gameplay. That's the most important thing. If it's got that sort of gameplay like that Modern Warfare has, where it just doesn't make me want to play more than a few games, it will not succeed like that long. And a lot of things will, you know, determine this. I'd say skill-based matchmaking could determine this. I'd say just the overall mechanics will determine this, but it needs to be replayable. It needs to have me to want to come back to it multiple times. If I get sick of it after a few games, we have a problem. Most Call of Duties, I'm usually fine with playing for a long time, but Modern Warfare had this thing where I could not play. Like, I could play one game, have a actually decent time, and then I'll play a second game or a third game, and I'll just be like, I can't do this anymore, man, I can't. And I'll have to, you know, wait till the next day or till later on to actually want to play again, because it's just not enjoyable. So It's got to have a good, solid, replayable gameplay experience, and I think they need to do something about Skillbase matchmaking to really make that happen for sure. Next up is a good progression system and overall just good rewards and unlocks. I want to have fun. I want to be able to grind for cool camos and cosmetics and prestige and such, and we don't know if prestige is going to be even in the game. Even if it's not there, I do think they could still have a good progression system in some way, shape, or form. We'll have to wait and see what that is. Hopefully it's not the Modern Warfare system, but we'll just see what happens. And in terms of cosmetics, like, yes, I know there's going to be the shop, but I hope there's at least a lot of, you know, unlockable things that we can do, like for Dark Matter, for example. Hopefully Dark Matter is a fun grind to go for, because Modern Warfare's Damascus grind wasn't very fun. I didn't go for it, but I got, like, you know, I think almost platinum on the ARs, and it's just not fun. The challenges they have in that game are just not good. They're not well designed for what I think would be enjoyable. Like, you shouldn't make us mount to get like 100 kills or whatever it was. That's just not a good challenge to do. It's not something that's tedious or something that makes you stop playing the game like you should be playing it, you know what I mean? So that's important, in my opinion. I have just a lot of cool things to unlock, some cosmetics, you know, skins and such. That would be nice. And last thing I'd say is just good overall maps. Now, we've gotten a taste of a few of the maps, but they need more. Maps, in my opinion, are one of the most important things to a Call of Duty multiplayer experience, and hopefully the rest of the maps are good in terms of how they look and, of course, in terms of how they play. And hopefully there's a lot of them as well. I want to see a lot of maps in this game, and I'm worried that we're not going to get a lot, but definitely I would take quality over quantity, so definitely make them good before you're just going to make a bunch of them. And then in terms of the DLC season, of course, we need a lot of new maps as well, and remakes. Throw some remakes as well, I don't mind that. Have some 12v12 ones, some 6v6 ones, mix and match them as much as you can, and just give us some replayable content through just better maps, you know what I mean? I just want maps that play well, because the alpha and beta maps, although they weren't the worst maps ever, they also weren't the best maps ever. So I definitely think they need to do some work on some of the maps, making them just play a little bit better. Just be a little bit more three-laned, a little bit more linear. I think they'd play a lot better, like some of the Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2 maps that we've had in the past. And last but not least, let's talk about zombies real quick. So zombies, also I'm going to say three things that I think zombies needs to succeed. First of all, we need some really solid Easter egg quests. I will say this a million times over, I think Easter egg quests are the most important thing to zombies currently. Ever since Black Ops 3, I think it's been the most important thing to make a map good or bad, is that Easter egg quest. So we really just need some fun and replayable quests that are not tedious, but are also not too easy, so they're too simple to do, because I want a challenge, but I also don't want it to be something that I really don't want to do again. So you have to make it kind of work for both ways. Have a good boss fight as well, have something just epic and insane with some good story thrown into it as well. And then on top of that, we need good rewards, not just for the Easter egg itself, but for just other things in the game. I'm talking in-game rewards, and I'm talking out-of-game rewards. So the battle pass is not enough, in my opinion. I want a lot of things that you earn for playing the game itself, like doing different side quests and different challenges, and you just earn cool things, maybe, you know, cosmetics or weapon blueprints or skins, or hell, even just like wonder weapons or something. Just give us a lot of crap like that. That would be awesome. And last but not least, we need just more things to do in terms of not just in the maps themselves, but even outside of the maps. So stuff like tournaments. I've been asking for some sort of a tournament system to be introduced in zombies forever. I think that could be awesome. More modes like grief or turned or gun game or something in zombies. They could do all sorts of awesome modes, and I think they need to implement more of those into zombies, so we just have more stuff to do other than just playing the few maps they give us over and over again. Like Black Ops 3 did not have enough to it. You just had Shadows of Evil and the Giant, and then Dead Ops Arcade 2. Like, that's not enough for replay value. You know, we need modes, we need other things to do, and it already seems like they're going to have some of that, but we need more. I'm talking just as much as humanly possible, so we just never get bored of it. And last but not least, let's talk a little bit about Cold War Warzone, because that's going to be implemented in like December, and it doesn't really sound like... The reason why I don't really want to touch on this too much is because it doesn't sound like it's going to even really be a part of Cold War at all. They're really trying to separate Warzone from Call of Duty, any Call of Duty games in general, so I don't even think we'd consider Warzone a part of Modern Warfare anymore. I mean, right now I'd consider it a part of Modern Warfare because it's in Modern Warfare, but I think they're going to really try to integrate it into its own separate download, so it's a separate application completely from any other COD experience. and we know kind of a little bit about it, like how they're going to implement the guns and such from Cold War into the Modern Warfare's engine, which I don't know how that's going to work, but all I'm asking for this Warzone experience, I just hope there's a lot of zombie stuff implemented into it, and I hope there's a new map that's just more colorful than what Verdansk is. That's really all I'm asking for when it comes to Cold War Warzone, even though it's not really technically part of Cold War. I think we should just consider Warzone its all its own COD experience now at this point. So, regardless, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Do I think it's going to be possible for this game to be better than Black Ops 2? I think all of those things are possible to happen. Everything I listed there can happen, and if it does, yes, it can definitely be better than Black Ops 2. They just need to nail those things I said in the video, and yeah, it'll do it. But, there's a few of them I'm a little bit worried about, especially the skill-based matchmaking side of multiplayer, and definitely some of maybe the post-launch stuff when it comes to zombies and multiplayer overall, because sometimes they drop the ball with post-launch content, and they start, not doing as much as they should, or just bringing out subpar content. I hope they don't do that. I hope it's solid stuff all throughout the season, and we get a great game overall. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.